Good morning, everybody. It is just now 7 a.m. Today is January 13th, and today is actually the start of my first flight attendant trip of 2022. As most of you know, at the end of December, I was hardly getting called for any trips on reserve, and then I actually was able to take the first 12 days off of January for us to move, and I had a little bit of a procedure done on my face, which most of you know about by now. So I wanted to take as much time off as possible that I could, but now the time for me to come back to work has arrived. I'm mostly excited, but I'm also a little bit nervous. I don't know why. I guess it kind of just feels like the first day back to school. All right, let's go inside. Let's go home, Luna. Look at her cute new bowl that we bought her. Yeah, Luna, you're just dripping water all over that, huh? Eric starts work every day at 7 a.m., so it actually works out really well because I usually have early mornings as well for work, but right now I have about an hour and 20 minutes until I need to leave, so let's go ahead and get ready.
I watch you as you drive. Do you know I'm looking? And I can't help but smile. Do you know how much I love you? You put my favorite song on. I put my feet up. And we just sing along. And I can't help but feeling just loving this moment. Can we stay here forever?
I am just about ready to leave. In order to stay on time, I need to leave my house in about 12 minutes, exactly. So right now I am just packing some food. I figured I would show you all what I meal prep since it's been a while that I've done that. I have 3 protein bars in here, and then on top I have some of these Rice Krispie treats, and then I am also bringing these soups, this one, and then this lentils one. And these are super easy, you just heat them up in a microwave. This is just some chicken and rice. I brought 2 of these. And then I am also bringing these 2 salads. This one is Mexican style Caesar, and this one is a cilantro avocado salad. I have a bunch of these little tangerines, apples, and some protein shakes. How I keep my food cold is I always keep it in this lunchbox, and then I put ice blocks on top of everything. And then once I get to the hotel, I make sure to put everything in the fridge. I got almost everything to fit in here. The only thing I need to put in my other bag were the apples. But it is 8:24 a.m. now. I wanted to be out the door by 8:30, so let's head to the airport. I forgot my sweater. Look at me, just forgetting things. Bye. I love you. Thank you. I'll give mommy a hug. Goodbye. Luna's like groaning. She's like, I don't want to do this. Bye, Luna. I love you, you be good girl. I just got to the DFW airport, and thank goodness I remembered on the way here that my employee parking pass expired. It expired December 31st, 2021, and I haven't flown since then, so I haven't had a chance to go pick up my new pass. So I had to just bite the bullet and pay to park in the regular terminal underground parking because I'm scared of my car getting towed, which in reality, that would probably cost more money anyways than just paying to park at the airport. Honestly, I don't know if my car would get towed, but I really don't want to take that risk. But right now it is 9:10 and my report time is 9:40, so I'm actually here with plenty of time. I'm just gonna put these little band-aids on my chin. As most of you know by now, I did get my beauty marks removed, and they're scabbing over right now. They're healing, but I just feel like for work and under the mask, I should put the band-aids on. Okay, band-aids are on. I don't know how well they're gonna stay on today because I put makeup on. Hair is up, and we are ready to get going. I forgot to tell you all today what our flights are. So we have 3 flights today. The first is from DFW, which is where I am based, to Gunnison, Colorado. And then we turn right around and we will fly from Gunnison, Colorado back to DFW. And then I think we sit at the airport for about 2 hours. And our last flight of the night is from Dallas to Pittsburgh. With all of that said, let's head into the airport and have a fabulous day of flying.
Loving this moment, can we
just landed in Gunnison, Colorado. The flight was about an hour and 40 minutes long. But you guys, look how beautiful it is out here. We have those snow-capped mountains. I have to laugh at myself. It's just been one of those mornings so far. I definitely need some time to get back in the swing of things because I spilled an entire cup of water on a little girl and I felt so bad. She was so sweet about it though, and the parents were super nice. That made me feel a lot better, but still, I just felt awful. And then somehow I completely missed a row during service as well. So later on in the flight, they rang their call late and we're like, I don't know what happened, but somehow like you skipped us. And so then I just felt even worse and I went back and obviously served them their snacks and beverages. But all right, you guys, it feels like a Monday even though it's a Tuesday. So I just need to get back in the swing of it, but we all make mistakes. The plane is empty now. We have about half an hour until we board our next flight. Like I mentioned earlier, we are going back to DFW. So I will see y'all when we get there. Just got back to DFW, safe and sound. Our flight was only an hour and 30 minutes. It was really quick. Now that we're here, we have about 2 or 3 hours, I think, until our next flight. So I'm just gonna sit here and relax, read, and maybe get some editing done while I wait for our next flight. I just got to my hotel in Pittsburgh. Our flight was great. It was 2 hours and 20 minutes and it was smooth except for just a little bit of turbulence at the end. And I will say I did much better with service on my last two flights. I didn't spill water on anyone and I didn't forget about anyone either. Let's do a room tour. I really like this hotel room. I feel like it's very simple but chic and just really nice. We have the large bed over here, bedside lamp and table on both sides, and then we have the fridge, a mirror, the long desk, and a large TV. We have the bathroom through here, and ooh, I really like this mirror. It's fancy. And what is that? Oh my gosh, it says the time on the side of the mirror. Wow, I didn't realize it was already 10:41 p.m. Something that I am really trying to do is before I sit down on the bed or go on my phone and get distracted, I am going to really try to get my hotel room ready for bed as soon as I get there. So first, that means getting the food I didn't eat into the fridge. Next is setting up all of my bathroom stuff so I can just hop in the shower and get ready quickly in the morning. All my toiletries are now ready to go. I have dental floss, lotion, my morning lotion, night lotion, some eye cream, my contacts. This is a cleansing balm that I use as makeup remover with a cloth, toothpaste, and I always put all of that stuff in here, and then all of my makeup is in this bag. Oh, and my toothbrush. I obviously cannot forget about that. In the shower, I just put my face wash right there, and I'll probably just use the hotel's body wash tonight. Laptop is out of my bag, as well as my journal, because I want to write a little bit before I go to sleep tonight. I also want to make sure I have all of the chargers that I know I'm going to use tonight plugged in. That took me less than 10 minutes to do all of that. I definitely feel better about not procrastinating, and now when I get out of the shower, I can start winding down and getting ready for bed. That shower felt amazing. The water temperature was so hot and the water pressure was awesome. I just finished journaling for the night and the random prompt that I just decided on was to write about 5 things I'm grateful for. The first one is I am grateful that me, Eric, and Luna are settling into our beautiful new apartment. The second one is I am grateful to have had a great first day back flying in the new year. Number 3, I am grateful for all of the healthy food I fueled my body with today. Number 4, I am grateful for all of the love and support that surrounds me. And number 5, I am grateful for my good health. Sometimes journaling can just be something as simple as writing down a few things that you're grateful for. And I really enjoy doing little exercises like that for my mind because it just really puts me in a really good mental place. And yeah, I always like to reflect on my day. And that's something that I am going to try to do a lot more in 2022 is at the end of each day, I really want to try to journal about something. It doesn't need to be what I'm grateful for. It could be so many other things. just kind of whatever comes to my mind, and that's what I thought of today. But anyways, it is late, so I am going to go to bed, and I will see you all tomorrow morning.
Good morning, everybody. I really slept in. It's 9 a.m. right now, but I feel great after a long night of sleep. But I have a random question for you all. Do you have like a morning ritual or something that you do every single day?
Because one of mine is I have to splash my face with cold water in the morning to help me wake up. I've done this every day since I was a kid.
I've always just turned the sink on, oh, that's like a little aggressive, and splashed my face with cold water. I don't know what it is about it, but it just really helped me wake up in the morning. And since I have done this for so long, where I just splash my face with cold water in the morning, if I don't do it, I feel like I don't wake up well.
I swear, I can just tell that it is cold out here today.
I still have a little over an hour before I need to be downstairs to head to the airport. So I'm just gonna eat breakfast in bed. I'm eating this Zone Perfect protein bar. You can get these from pretty much any grocery store. And then I'm gonna take my vitamins. I bought this cute little pill organizer from Amazon that I really like, and I will link it below.
I am also reading this book right now called Maybe Someday by Colleen Hoover. If you guys have been watching my channel for a while, you know she is currently one of my favorite authors.
I'm 65% of the way done with the book, and I will say that it is really, really good, okay? Don't get me wrong, but out of all of the Colleen Hoover books that I have read so far, this is probably my least favorite, and I don't want that to be confused with saying that it's bad, because it's not bad at all. It's just she is such a good author that, like, all of her books are amazing, but this one just happens to be my least favorite of all of the ones I've read so far. But I need to start getting ready for work. So I'm not gonna wear any makeup today because my skin is feeling a bit irritated. So I just wanna give it a little bit of a break. And also one of my scabs fell off while I was sleeping. But a few ladies have messaged me and asked what eyeshadow palettes I've been wearing. So I thought real quick I would just show you the different palettes that I have been rotating through. This Urban Decay Prince, this Urban Decay Naked Reloaded, and this Morphe Ashley Strong. And then these are what all of the different shades look like for the makeup. And I always get all of my makeup from the store Ulta, but I'm pretty sure you can get it from Sephora as well. I'm just about ready to go now, and I completely forgot to tell you all that this is a 3-day trip. So yesterday was obviously day one, today is day two, and then I will be home by tomorrow night. And today we have two flights. We are going from Pittsburgh back to Dallas, and then we are going from Dallas to Key West International Airport. I am so excited for that layover. I have never been there before. I think each flight is gonna be about 2.5 hours long, so let's get out of here and have a great day.